my book is West of Sunset. It's a romance about the golden age of Hollywood seen through the eyes of America's great romantic writer, F. Scott Fitzgerald. This is after the crack-up, after he's lost everything. He's lost Zelda, he's lost his daughter, he has no money, he's drunk, he's not working. And to pay his bills, he goes out to Hollywood to try to write for the movies. And he signs on with Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, I know, the great studio. And so we get to see him at the Garden of Allah, living with Dorothy Parker, Humphrey Bogart, Robert Benchley, and working at MGM on the same hallway was Dorothy Parker, Aldous Huxley, James M. Cain, and the new kid, Fitzgerald. He falls in love with Sheila Graham, who's a gossip columnist, while he's still making visits out to North Carolina to see Zelda. So he goes on these strange vacations with Zelda. The doctors let her out of the asylum. And then, of course, he's so sad that he begins to drink again, and he goes back to Sheila in Hollywood, and he loses his job in Hollywood, but he can still pay his bills, and he makes enough money to work on his new book, The Last Tycoon. We see Los Angeles of that time as a garden spot, not the sort of the dead, soulless Los Angeles, but the beautiful, the mountains and the ocean in Malibu. And Fitzgerald, he's renewed, I think, by falling in love. He regains his love of life, his romantic view of the world. And we see that in The Last Tycoon. So if The Last Tycoon is a Roman éclat about his life, this book is the Roman éclat about him writing his life in The Last Tycoon. He's a fascinating figure. He's a legendary character, but he's always the outsider looking in at people who have more success and more money than he does. And nowhere more than here in Hollywood, where the people surrounding him are, they're Oscar winners, they're superstars, they're so rich. And here's a man he can't even afford to pay his rent. I think it's the ability to focus readers on things they otherwise would completely miss. The big stories that are right out there in the open. One of my books is about a woman whose husband goes to prison. We have millions of prisoners, but no one talks about them or their families. Or to talk about the downturn in the economy, I've written a book about a Red Lobster restaurant, a chain restaurant that goes out of business, and it's the manager that we focus on. Who cares about a little crummy restaurant? Well, he cares. It's his job. It's his identity. In America, it's often what we do is who we are. Take away what we do, then who are we? So you can focus the reader on what you think is important about American culture rather than what, say, the larger mass media thinks is.